Welcome to Coding Droplets. In this video, we'll explore the powerful features of collection view control in .NET MAUI. Whether you are new to .NET MAUI or looking to enhance your skills, join us on this exciting journey as we unlock the full potential of the collection view. Let's dive in together. The collection view control in .NET MAUI offers a powerful alternative to the traditional list view control, providing enhanced functionality and a more modern approach to display collection of data. It provides more flexibility in terms of layout options, allowing you to choose between lists, grids, carousels, and other visually appealing arrangements. Collection View offers advanced features such as item selection, refreshing, and the ability to add headers and footers. In summary, the collection view in .NET MAUI offers a more versatile and feature-rich solution for displaying collection of data. We'll continue using the same project that we used in the previous videos to demonstrate the carousel view and list view controls. First, we need to create a new content page named collection view demo inside the pages folder. Then, let's navigate to the app.xaml.cs class and modify the main page property to point to our newly created collection view demo page. This ensures that the page will be loaded when launching the application. Within the collection view demo page, we can start by removing the automatically generated vertical stack layout and the label. Instead, we'll directly place a collection view in the content page. Similar to the carousel view and list view controls, the collection view also has an item source property where we can provide the items to be displayed. In this case, we'll use an array of strings as we did in the previous videos. Let's begin with the first item labeled as item 1. Following this, we can duplicate the item and update the values to create item 2, item 3, item 4, item 5, item 6, and item 7. Now let's run the project and observe the collection view in the emulator. You'll notice that the items are listed similarly to a list view control. However, when attempting to interact with the items, you may notice that they are not selectable by default. The selectable property of the collection view is disabled. We'll soon demonstrate how to enable the selection in the collection view control. Furthermore, the collection view control also offers the flexibility to define the appearance of each item through the item template property. Within the item template, we can utilize a data template to specify the layout for each item. To begin, let's place a vertical stack layout within the data template. Inside the vertical stack layout, we'll include a label. To display the actual content of each item, we can bind the text property of the label to the corresponding item in the item source. Since we are using a string array as the item source, we can use a dot symbol to reference the current item. Additionally, we can enhance the visual presentation of the items by providing a background color for the vertical stack layout. Once we run the application and observe it in the emulator, you will notice that the items are now displayed with the specified background color. To further refine the layout, we can assign some padding for the vertical stack layout. Additionally, we can horizontally center align the label within the vertical stack layout. Upon running the application in the emulator, you will see that the items are now separated by some space and the text is aligned to the horizontal center. To create a better visual separation between the items, we can also provide some margin for the vertical stack layout. As a result, in the emulator you will notice a distinct white space between the items, providing a clearer distinction. Another important property of the collection view is the items layout. Items layout allows us to define the layout style to be used for displaying the items. By default, the items layout value is set to vertical list. This layout represents a single column list that grows vertically as new items are added. In the emulator, you might not notice any visible difference as we have assigned vertical list, which is the default layout. Let's explore the horizontal list items layout next. This layout represents a single row list that grows horizontally as new items are added. In the emulator, you will see that the items are arranged in a horizontal list and we can scroll from left to right or vice versa. Moving on, we'll now examine the vertical grid items layout. This layout represents a multi-column grid that grows vertically as new items are added. It is important to specify the number of columns to be displayed. For this demonstration, let's set the column count to 2. In the emulator, you will observe that the list is arranged as a grid with 2 columns. Let's modify the column count to 3 and see the changes. Now you can see that the list arranged as a grid with 3 columns, providing a different visual representation. Next, we'll explore the horizontal grid items layout. This layout represents a multi-row grid that grows horizontally as new items are added. Similar to the vertical grid, we need to specify the number of rows to be displayed. For this demonstration, let's set the row count to 2. When observed in the emulator, you will notice that the list is arranged as a grid with 2 rows. Let's adjust the row count to 3 and see the result. Now you can see the list is arranged as a grid with 3 rows, providing a different visual layout. Additionally, let's explore how we can enable selection in the collection view control. The collection view provides a property called selection mode, which offers 3 different options: multiple, none, and single. By default, the selection mode property is set to none, meaning that no selection behavior is enabled. In this state, clicking on any item will not select it. Let's try single selection mode next. In the emulator, you'll notice that I am now able to select any one of the items. Upon selection, the selected item will be visually highlighted, indicating the active selection. Now let's explore the multiple selection mode. In the emulator, you will observe that I can select multiple items by clicking on them. Additionally, clicking on a selected item will deselect it, allowing for easy manipulation of the selected items. The ability to enable selection in the collection view provides flexibility in interacting with the items based on the specific user requirements. Moving forward, let's explore how we can assign the item source property of the collection view from C# code. To begin, let's remove the previously provided item source from the XAML file, as we'll now populate the collection view dynamically. Before proceeding further, let's create a new model class named Country inside the Models folder. This model class will represent the data structure for displaying countries in the collection view. Within the Country class, we can define the properties such as country name to store the name of the country, ISO code to store the ISO code, and flag URL to store the URLs of the images representing the country flags. Now inside the collectionview.demo.cs class, let's create a new method named getCountries that will fetch the country list. This method will return a list of country objects. For this demonstration, we'll hardcode a few country objects in the list as an example. You can expand this logic to fetch the data from any data source. Once the list of country objects are created, we need to assign a name to the collection view in the XAML file so that we can access it from the C# code. Finally, within the collectionviewdemo.cs class, we can assign the list of country objects to the item source property of the collection view. This will dynamically populate the collection view with the country data fetched from the getCountries method. By assigning the item source from the C# code, we can gain the flexibility to fetch and display data dynamically based on various conditions and data sources. Next, let's proceed with making modifications to the collection view's item template design. We'll start by removing the previous vertical stack layout and create a new design for the items. First, let's place a frame with some margin to provide visual distinction. Inside the frame, we'll add a grid. Within the grid, we need to assign the grid.column definitions. For this demonstration, let's set the grid to have 2 columns with assigned widths. Now we can add an image to the item template. We'll bind the image's source property to the flag URL property of the country object. Additionally, we can assign the grid cell position to place the image in the first column. In the second column of the grid, we'll add a vertical stack layout. To enhance the visual appearance, we can assign some padding for the vertical stack layout. Additionally, we'll set the vertical options for the vertical stack layout to center. Within the vertical stack layout, we'll add a label to display the country name. We can bind the country name property to the text property of the label. To improve the readability, we can increase the font size and make it bold. Next, we need another label to display the ISO code. We can bind the ISO code property to the text property of this label. To differentiate it, we can make the font style italic. Now let's run the project and observe the collection view in the emulator. You will see that the countries are populated along with their respective flag images and ISO codes, as per the modified item template design. Let's try changing the item's layout to vertical grid with the two columns and see the changes in the emulator. You will notice that the items are now arranged in two columns and the size of the image is adjusted accordingly. Next, let's explore a property of the collection view called EmptyView, which allows us to show a custom message when the item source is empty. To demonstrate this feature, let's provide the message "no data available" as the content of the EmptyView property. Additionally, we'll assign an empty list as the item source property. This will trigger the display of the custom message when the collection view does not have any items to display. Let's run the application and observe the changes in the emulator. You'll see that it now shows the custom message "no data available" when the collection view is empty. To further improve the visual representation, let's change the item's layout property to vertical list. This layout will ensure that the message is displayed in the center of the collection view. Moving forward, let's explore how we can assign a header to the collection view. The collection view control provides a property called header, which allows us to define a custom header for the collection view. To demonstrate this, we'll place a vertical stack layout inside the header property. Within the vertical stack layout, we can assign a background color and padding to enhance the visual appearance. Inside the vertical stack layout, we'll add a label with the text "countries". We can align the label to horizontally center and format the font size and font attributes as desired. Now let's run the project and observe the changes in the emulator. You will see that a header labeled "countries" is displayed above the items in the collection view. The ability to assign a header to the collection view provides a way to add descriptive information or titles to the collection of items, enhancing the overall user experience. Additionally, the collection view control offers a property called footer, which allows us to display a custom footer for the collection view. To demonstrate this feature, we'll place a vertical stack layout inside the footer property. Inside the vertical stack layout, we'll add a label with the text "coding droplets". This can serve as a footer message or any other relevant information. Now, when we run the project and observe the changes in the emulator, you'll notice that as you scroll down, the footer labeled "coding droplets" is displayed at the bottom of the collection view. The footer provides a way to add additional content or information at the end of the collection view, enriching the overall user experience and allowing for enhanced customization. Now let's observe how the header and footer appear when using different items layout options. First, let's explore the vertical grid items layout. As you can see in the emulator, the header is positioned at the top and the footer is placed where the items end. This layout provides a vertical grid arrangement for the items while maintaining the position of the header and footer. Next, let's try the horizontal list items layout. In the emulator, you'll notice that the header is positioned on the left side, and as you scroll to the right, you'll find the footer at the right end. This layout offers a horizontal list arrangement while preserving the placement of header and footer. Similarly, in the case of horizontal grid, the header is located on the left side and the footer is positioned on the right side, maintaining the consistency of the horizontal list layout. For the purposes of our current design, it is recommended to switch back to the vertical list items layout as it aligns well with the design elements we have created, providing a visually appealing and cohesive user experience. Congratulations on completing this exploration of powerful collection view control in .NET MAUI. Make sure to check out the playlist link in the video description to access the full range of tutorials and expand your knowledge further. Thank you for joining us on this exciting journey through .NET MAUI. Stay inspired, keep learning, and continue pushing the boundaries of app development. Until next time, happy coding!